Good evening, everybody, and welcome to this Test 3 match, Wales versus Uganda. We're all tied one apiece coming into this last test and all to play for. As Wales come out to the court, another change to Emily Handyside's game day squad as she looks to give opportunities. Lucy Howes comes back into the defensive end with Ellen Morgan getting her first call up. Will she get her first cap this afternoon? The starting seven remains consistent. For Uganda, their game day squad stays the same. However, Fred Maguire will change up his starting seven with Sandra Nambirige starting at goal defence and Florence Aduna getting her place back in at wing defence.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you are able to,
and the Welsh crowd in song. Let me quickly give you the starting sevens for each side. Uganda will be playing at yellow at goalkeeper, Konduna. At goal defence, Nambirige. At wing defence, Adunia. At centre, Bargala. At wing attack, Achola. At goal attack, Captain Irene Yaru. And at goal shooter, Mary Cholhock. For the home side, Wales, at goalkeeper, Liam Middleton. Goal defence, Powell Davis. Wing defence, Jones. Wing attack, Dyke. Centre, O'Dwyer. Goal attack, Yarrington. And goal shooter, Georgia Rowe. The umpires for tonight's game will be James Thomas from England and Leonard Masso from South Africa, with Kate Mann, the reserve umpire. Well, I'm Pamela Cookie, and I'm delighted that I'll be joined tonight by Aileen Roberts, former Celtic Dragon and Welsh international, in commentary to take you through this. The umpire's just waiting for their signal to get this going. But Aileen, what are you looking for this third match?
Well, I'm definitely looking forward to see how all of this is going to pan out for this third test match. See, as you said, one apiece. And I guess we'll find out as the ball is about to pass into the first centre match.
I say, and we're off. Uganda in the yellow, going to the right of our screens, have that first centre pass. And a great defensive work by Wales in Yarrington, Aileen.
Yarrington there almost just putting off Uganda on that ball. Great defensive work. Didn't even touch the ball until it was dropped by Uganda. Great work shutting down that space.
But Uganda get it back and now have the opportunity. There, Cholo, a wing attack. Player of the match last night. She was on fire. Looking to bring some catalyst and calmness into this Ugandan attack inside. And there's a lovely pass from Bagala to Cholok under the post. They recycle. And Captain Iyaru, goal attack under the post. She nets.
Of course, she nets. Her stats for these three matches, well, the previous two matches have been outstanding. And Cholok yesterday, you know, last night's match, found her feet, different to Wednesday night's match. So I'm excited to see what both of them can bring to this match tonight.
Yes, we missed it last night's match. Sorry, saw Uganda come right away with it, especially in that second half, winning 40-64. So Wales will be looking to stem this start that Uganda seem to have collected, going up 2-0 now on those first two centre passes.
Yeah, Wales losing their first centre pass there to Uganda, but a great turnover. They unfortunately lost the ball, so a great turnover, and Cholok having no problem putting that. Just working the way around, and Iyaru working her way around Cholok there to put it in. And here she goes for her third goal of the match. Again, no problem putting that in the net.
Right, Shona O'Dwyer at centre for Wales takes that centre pass. This centre pass crucial, with Georgia Rowe coming out of the circle. Very uncharacteristic for her at a goal shooter in her style of play.
Absolutely. And as we were saying last night, you know, she needs to be working a little bit more now. If these short, sharp passes between Yarrington and Dyke and O'Dwyer are not getting there and not working, then it is on Georgia Rowe to come out and do that work. And as we've just seen, she's doing it.
And a little shooter to shooter and a high five from Yarrington to her shooter teammate, Georgia Rowe. Wales are on the board. 3 for Uganda, 1 to Wales. See this zonal marking that Wales are trying to set up to stem that flow, but Uganda find a way through. When you get in on that edge of the circle, it's easy to get into 6'7" Mary Cholok.
Of course it is. And this zonal defence has proved to work well for Wales. The small zonal defence, the diamond setup defence. But as we saw last night as well, with Achula, she is very, very good at finding that space and creating that deep drive to pocket. And almost disrupting that zonal defence from Wales. So they need to make sure they don't get too drawn into that drive.
Yarrington, calm and control. She's lifted. She's got the voice early on, wanting to give that fight into this Welsh team.
She always lifts the crowd, Yarrington. She's a bit like Nia Jones in that retrospect of lifting up her voice. But yeah, of course, her shooting stats again, phenomenal. And she gets a turnover, helped by Nia Jones for that one.
A goal attack doing some defensive work. Always the way, obviously. And Georgia Rose, she pays dividends to that. Gets another one back on the mark for Wales, and it's their centre pass. Nia Jones unable to collect that. The great pressure from Achola. That was a battle yesterday. Both of them giving so much to each other.
It was a battle yesterday, but as called by almost every player on the court there, I think, for Wales, just a mishandle there from Ochola. Again, uncharacteristic for her, but I think it was just quite a bit of a mishandle on the ball. Couldn't find her feet. Unlike Georgia Rowe, who found her feet on the baseline there and kept the ball into O'Dwyer.
The Welsh fielders trying to make every possession count. Yarrington steps across to keep the defender out of the way. Unable to net, but Rowe is there for the rebound. You would hope so, all 6'5" of her. And she scores. We are level. Big hands over pressure from Wales in defence. Not letting them be able to sight Mary Czolak in the back. But Achola, that's one of the reasons she got player of the match yesterday. That fearlessness, putting that ball into a goal shooter.
Her fees to Czolak on almost every ball. They're almost pinpoint accurate, aren't they? And putting it up from her fight, all 5'5" of her on the court to someone like 6'7", the accuracy of that feed is so important. And she almost nails it every time.
Dyke hugging that circle edge, trying to wait for her shooters to come through with Yarrington and Kadondi lock legs together. Contact call from Yarrington.
I think she just found her feet the wrong side there of Kadondi. Uganda win the ball coming down the court.
Uganda not afraid to spread, but Leah Middleton, she runs hard out on Mary Czolak, gets a tip, but ball still in Uganda's hands. Again, she fights for possessions on the outside of that circle. But it pays no means to Uganda, does it? They still get it in under the post.
Of course, and Czolak, you know, that kind of shooter that is happy to just stand there, take the ball and shoot, and is happy again to come out and take ball just outside the circle, in pocket, just above pocket. And it's very effective for them if they haven't got that deep drive. But O'Dwyer gets her hand in on that ball. That quick turnover off the back line for Uganda. Let's see if we can get that pinpoint accuracy feed.
Ah, and Ella Powell Davis straight on that rebound. Oh, but Wales, they had that opportunity. But that mistake, sending the ball off the sideline and it's back to Uganda.
It's always that first ball, isn't it? It's actually, I think, statistically, the first ball that you send after a turnover is the most likely to be turned over again by the other team. So it's that first pass has to be under control and collected and composed.
Oh, beautiful. First phrase from Bethan Dyke on the line. That dodge to get herself free and then just all eyes for Georgia Rowe in the circle.
And Georgia Rowe even keeping her feet exactly where they were meant to be after being knocked over a little bit there by Kadondi, but managed to sink that ball in the net beautifully.
Patience from Uganda. They just seems like they've got all the time in the world when they've got ball in hand.
And it's the same in the warm-up, you know, they do it nice and easy, nice patient play, and they seem to know exactly where all their players are at all times. But they're also, don't underestimate their feistiness, isn't it? They're always feisty and they will always go for ball no matter where it is.
And then we see an example of that now there. Nambirige, a goal defence, getting a tip on it and her teammate Kadondi picking it up. Czolak exits the circle again. But those offloads just need a little bit of work. They're getting tips, aren't they? Not quite reaching their intended target cleanly.
They are getting tips. And I think, you know, Wales are currently working very hard on shutting down the space around Uganda and confusing that space. So if you're sending that ball and you're not quite sure if it's going to get there, your pass might be affected. So Wales are working very hard to do so. But Uganda need to work now to put enough of the can And that perfect example from Bagala to put that brilliant ball into Mary Trollope there. Lovely work. Defence drawn out. Perfect pass.
Oh, well, Uganda have taken the scoreline out. 5-10 in this first quarter of the last test match in this three-match test series. If you're just joining us, it's one apiece. Wales won on Wednesday night. Uganda came back firing last night to take the second test. So all to play for tonight. Oh, well seen from
Adunia, I believe, in wing defence.
Indeed, just great off the mark, vision into the circle. She didn't start in last night's game, but it's back in the squad and on that starting seven wing defence. Great play from her, hustler, but also not afraid to look in that attacking end.
No, she didn't start on last night, but she did start on Wednesday night. So I think she's kind of regained her little starting position there. But I believe we did have Nambiri Gate starting in wing defence last night, who's now moved to the goal defence position, of course. So when we did lose Nakito due to injury, she moved back on to the wing defence position. So obviously has remained there after earning a spot.
Lots of depth in this Ugandan side. And the battle of the centres, Odwyer and Bagala, both going for everything. And it's the sideline to Wales. Oh, quick give and go. But would have liked that pass to come a little bit quicker from Yarrington. So it didn't get that fumble, but she nets anyway. Nice. Strength from Dyke on the circle edge. Yarrington playing the baseline. Shooter to pop to Georgia Rowan with 4 minutes left in this first quarter. It's a two-point game. 9 to Wales, 11 to Uganda.
It's getting closer now, isn't it? And that battle in the circle on both sides of the court. The battle with Powell Davis and Middleton against Ayaru and Trollope. Which sees Ayaru now sink that extra shot. But it really does compare to that battle with Georgia Rowan Kadundi. I think Jones was looking for that long ball then, but it wasn't quite on.
That's good discipline to pull it back in again. Wait for the next option to come through and keeping that momentum going from Wales. Just getting one off the board, trying to peg back this lead that Uganda have gained in this first quarter.
We can see there that Welsh defensive setup, can't we? We can see that Yarrington was keeping her wing defence, Adunia, as far as she could onto the sideline. Beth and Dyke doing the same. Forcing Uganda to play high into their third.
Pulls Mary Trollope out the circle again. But Trollope, she always seems to find herself in a little bit of space.
Those little pop bombs under the net again seems to struggle with, but no problem with this one this time.
Yeah, she doesn't like it, does she? Yarrington from mid-range, part of the leadership group. She is helping co-captains Jones and Dyke to lift this side, and she's doing it again in defence. But it's the Chola ready to pick up that loose pass. It's so difficult. I know we keep saying it, but when you do get that ball so close, either on the circle edge or just in the goal shooting circle, to be able to play that ball, to be able to get a ball off Mary Trollope.
Yeah, it is very difficult. And credit to Middleton. Mm-hmm. She is doing all she can for it. And as we're just talking about a defensive side, there is a defensive swap coming on for Uganda. I believe it's the goal defence that's coming off for Uganda, Nambirige. Mm-hmm. And on we come, the injured player from last night.
Christine.
That is Nakito.
Yeah, 22-year-old Christine Akito made a recovery. Was there, do you think it was an injury? I didn't quite see whether anything had happened or a tactical thing that Fred Magura, head coach of Uganda, wanting to do.
I think it's more of a tactical. I don't see her like in injured or in pain. She's not seeing the physio or anything. So I think it is more of a tactical. You know, they might have wanted to start her because of how well she performed at the end of last night's match. And obviously, Christine Nikito has made a recovery from her a bit of a niggle yesterday. So they were happy with their performance.
And we're just under a minute left of this quarter. Uganda managed to just keep that lead. 11 plays 16. Wales with the opportunity now with Georgia Rowe. And she puts it through the net. There's time though with 43 seconds on the clock. Uganda with the centre pass. Bagala takes it back to Nikito, just coming on at goal defence for Uganda. Captain Iara at goal attack. Bagala, Sholok. Not afraid to play this round, but just a little push there from Dyke on Adunia. And I said they have time, but this clock is being eaten up.
Wow, 16 seconds is quite a long time in a netball match, isn't it? As we all know, Wales will have to rush back for this one.
Oh, and not going to help themselves with that centre pass. You have to receive the first ball after the centre pass in that centre third. So possession goes to Uganda. And the whistle goes. 12 plays 17. Welsh Feathers 12. Uganda She Cranes a 17. A-line. First quarter reaction from you.
We've definitely seen Wales come out to this one wanting to bring that battle back into the match. And as we all know, the physicality between these two teams will always be there on court. Uganda, again, not willing to let anything go, have come back as strong as they finished last night. Not a long recovery time between both matches, so it wouldn't be a surprise to see tired bodies out there tonight. But yeah, very good start for both teams, I believe, with only a 5-goal difference at the moment. So Wales started off well, brought their defensive strategy back into it. We saw it at times, but it needs to be more consistent from Wales. Uganda finding those deep pocket drives from their winger Takacholo and from their centre Bagala and finding Mary easily. Wales struggling a little bit more to find Georgia Rowe in that shooting circle, but using Yarranton a little bit more to move that space and that ball around. Dyke finding those pocket drives as well as Shona O'Dwyer. So attackingly on both sides, working very well. Defensively on both sides, I believe, need a little bit more in their setup.
Nice. Well, I was always taught to say if you're within five going into the next quarter, the game is still in your hand. So for Wales, what one key thing will you say that they would have learned from the past two test series and this first quarter now take into the second quarter?
Definitely from last night's match, I think they might have just let Uganda play way too freely. So they let them have the space they wanted. They let them run away with the ball a bit too much, and they were following behind a bit. So Wales really need to stop them in their tracks with their play. Once they get into that momentum, it's easy for them to run away with the game. So Wales really need to stop them in their tracks and make sure that when a ball is taken, they have to reevaluate every single ball. Because once it's a pass, 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 pass in, it's difficult to stop the momentum. For Uganda, Wales can do that at times. We have seen it, you know, Shona O'Dwyer passing it to Dyke, to Yarranton, and then it's in. So Wales need to pick that up a bit more. For Uganda, their passages of play are working very well. Defensively, they could also look to shut those options down, force Wales to play a little bit wider because they do like to play short and sharp and in the middle channels. So for Uganda to shut that down. So I think both of them are playing their own game plans much better tonight than they were yesterday. And just to stick to their plans as they were meant to do, and they will come out then as a much better contested match.
Good. Well, that first test series was on Wednesday night, and Wales took it in that historic win, 57-45. Then last night, Uganda, an extra 48 hours on a UK soil, and back to what we know of Uganda, they won that match of 40-64. So one apiece. Now going into this second quarter, Uganda have got their neck up. They're ranked seventh in the world. Wales are ranked ninth in the world, so would expect them to be at that little bit higher level. But Wales are not letting them go off too easily.
No, and you know, between these two rankings, there's only 7 ranking points difference, with Tonga sitting in the middle. So it's not a massive difference between them in terms of ranking points. And yes, you have the numbers, but however, we do see Wales contesting with these kind of teams quite often now, playing Uganda, Ukraine a few times, and coming over to play them. So they have played them a few times before the World Cup. So they are, you know, teams that they can contest with and play against and bring out the best in them in competition.
So just taking a quick scan on the court, see if there's any changes have been made in that quarter time. And we do see one in that centre position.
Yes, Ellen Morgan has come on now and is taking her first cap for Wales. Another new Welsh feather being capped here. So Shona O'Dwyer has been taken to the bench and Ellen Morgan has taken her starting position.
And we're off. Uganda take the centre pass. Chollock comes out to help and release off that second phase. And we also see in the attacking end, Dyke has come off the court for Wales and Shona O'Dwyer has moved back into the wing attack position, but focusing on Uganda's shot and they put it through the net. Morgan at centre, just come on. O'Dwyer wing attack, finds Yarrington. That partnership with Georgia Rowe has been going for quite a few years now, but they're really starting to get a lot more game time together.
Yeah, definitely. You know, there were years where Georgia Rowe moved to 7 Stars to play. Now, obviously, back at the Cardiff Dragons. And it's nice to see them both playing there now at Cardiff Dragons, having that extra game time together through the season, having played together in university at Cardiff Met University. So their partnership has been there for years, like you say, and it's evident, you know, when they play together, they always know where both each other are. And it's a nice partnership to see.
Ah, solid strength for Miara to take that ball with 2 defenders on her. But Morgan gets the contact call as Powell Davis tries to get round her, but to no luck. And it's those quick shooter-to-shooter passes. Defenders have got no chance.
No, and if you're going from, you know, Iyaru's pass up to Chollock, which is going to be that extra height pass, isn't it? It's very difficult. But we have seen Leah Middleton have that little tip pass, have a tip to that pass on Wednesday night and on last night. So she is able to do it with that her elevation in her jump.
Oh, Leah Middleton, player of the match on Wednesday night. Get on her first cap for Wales.
Outstanding match for her on Wednesday night.
So looking now to see what she can do against Mary Chollock, Netball Super League champion with Loughborough Lightning. And there's one of those tips you talked about. And Morgan ready to help her teammate. But Wales are unable to even get it past the line at the top end of the D.
Again, like we said, statistically, that first ball that you give is always the one that gets turned over. But Ellen Morgan, a Team Bath player, absolutely wonderful backup to her teammate there, taking the ball from the back on the side of the back line back into court. Just unfortunate for Wales to lose it there.
Well, she is a dual international of England athletics as well, so she's got that athletic ability. And there's Leah Middleton again, putting the pressure on Chollock, and Chollock goes offside. Better transition from Wales. Yarrington found on the top of the circle.
Yarrington and Rowe just find that little partnership there. They always have like a little plan for themselves once they get stuck in between 2 defence. And it's working really nicely.
And they take Uganda's centre pass. Obviously, for those that don't know, centre passes alternate after each goal is scored. Good strong hold from Rowe into the backspace. and it's on 15 plays 20. They brought it back to that 5-goal difference they had coming into the second quarter. And Nia Jones running onto it causes the mistake from Uganda. Achola's looking to James Thomas, the umpire, saying, "My hand was pulled." But look, very difficult to see.
It is difficult. And these umpires we have, you know, they are very, very good umpires, top-level umpires. And even then, any umpire, you have 3 seconds to calculate every single thing that's going on with one player. It is a difficult thing to do, umpires.
Oh, definitely, I could not be one. And also, with the new rules as well, the new adaptations to them, they've got so much to think about, players and umpires, that it's going to be a learning curve for all. But I think the rule changes have definitely added to the game and will make it better.
They have added to the game, and we've seen it from Wednesday night and for last night and tonight. Little tips and little things that are happening. Leah Middleton there coming straight out for the interception. She saw Tollock run for that ball.
So a dodge from Nia Jones to be able to pull that high one in as well. So umpire Leonard Masso just calling time so that the floor can be wiped after Nia Jones's roll. Ball.
The battle between Jones and Achola at the minute is wonderful to see, isn't it? They are really, both of them, bringing out all technical elements of the game. We have some wonderful rolls and dodges and sidesteps and movements, but none of them willing to give up to the other.
Sometimes your game lifts, doesn't it? When you're up against an opponent that's just giving you that battle all the way through, challenging you, you want to up your game that bit more. And I think, like you say, both of them are really stepping up to the pressure that each other are putting on themselves.
Yeah, you can let your game drop. Do you know what I mean? You have to up your game to match your opponent. And if they're doing the same, you're just going to keep upping and upping and upping.
Oh, nice little reverse pass from Yarrington. We saw a few no-look passes last night, but her skill and her ability to play the ball, really, really good.
Really lovely. A lot of bodies on the floor here at the moment, all over the court from Wales and from Uganda.
So yeah, finally we get that goal and Wales bring it back to 4. Just under 9 minutes left of the second quarter. 16 to Wales, 20 to Uganda, and a long ball in from Yarrington, but unable to find her target with Kadondi. Great elevation.
Great elevation. Georgia Rowe just let go of that hold a little bit too soon on that ball. So the space that the ball was dropping into ended up being Kadondi's ball.
That's real 101, isn't it? When you're a holding shooter, don't move until that ball has passed your head.
Don't move until the ball is in the air. has passed your defender and is your ball.
So just 3 goals the difference. Uganda will be looking to up their play a little bit more so to get that deficit increased. Chance now off this centre pass with Bagalo at centre. She goes wide to Achola, who finds Mary Chollock. She takes a big step in, but draws the contact call and nets.
Shona O'Dwyer again on the ground there. She's drawing in a lot of that contact, isn't she? From a Dunya wing defence.
Oh, lovely, lovely play. So slick. Why was that so good?
It was beautiful. We had Yarrington drawing into pocket to the baseline and drawing defence with her. But then that little cut back and taking the ball in also drew defence away from Rowe. So when she got the ball in, it was a lovely quick pass. It was absolutely stunning to watch.
And I just like that bit play we just saw from Uganda in terms of James Thomas umpire allowing advantage to be played, even though Middleton had come out and caused that contact. But you don't want to put the attacking team at a disadvantage by calling a contact call and stopping play. Yarrington finding some great front holds, isn't she?
She is. She's a very, very strong player. She's very athletic. You can see her on court, like we have said, for the past couple of games. She will run and run. She's a workhorse, and she will hold herself strong. And she's not a short shooter for a goal attack, you know. She's, I would say, about 5'8", maybe?
5'10".
5'10". So she is quite a tall goal attack. So she is able to have that stronghold and that partnership with Georgia Rowe, like we said. Lovely.
Leah Middleton putting the pressure on Mary Chalk. But that pressure can build over a game, can't it? And by the time you get to the fourth quarter, you're like, wow, I feel it now.
Yeah, of course. And I think coming off Wednesday's game into last night's game, Middleton might have felt a little bit like, tonight I am really going to give it. And she had a really good game last night, not taking that away from her. But I think tonight now she's really ready for it, and she wants to show what she can do against Chalk. Yeah.
Nikita, goal defence, finds her captain Iyaru. Takes a little knock from Adwaya. Nikita just needing to set the penalty pass. Oh, great take from Bagala, taking the ball off the line. And
great take from Bagala. Like, Nia Jones saw that coming, a mile off. Morgan was on the other side, but a really nice take, taking the ball away from the defender. Middleton is absolutely ecstatic with these tips, isn't she? And it's really building in her. The more she takes, the more she gets, the more she will actually manage to accomplish.
Well, not Welsh by birth, but a Welsh grandparent. I think she had a coffee with Nia Jones, and Nia was like, "You're not by any chance have any Welsh relatives?" She said, "Actually, I do." The day before trials, she wasn't even set to trial. And now she's starting goalkeeper, getting player of the match on their first test, and leading that defensive end for Wales. So just three goals the difference with Uganda on the attack. 21 plays 24. This is the tighter game we wanted to see. Oh, and Ella Powell Davis has hit the floor and she looks in a lot of pain.
I think she might have hit her back there and she went on the way down there. She is quite a lot of pain. Physio straight on the court for her. Wales gathered together. So do Uganda.
Yeah, so time has been called. Right, so to give her some time to be seen to and assess the situation. Wales regroup with co-captain Nia Jones talking to her side, try and keep them focused in this game with this stoppage.
Yeah, and it's, you know, it's always difficult when one of your own players is taken to the ground with an injury and is being assessed, but you have to keep focused on the match. You have to make sure that your mind is where it's supposed to be. And I think we can see Alex Johnson over there warming up, being spoken to by Natalie Roddy, the assistant coach.
Yeah, Natalie Roddy just joining this Welsh side as assistant coach, as you say, in November last year, but has had a real impact on their defensive end.
Yeah, she has. And we can see it through court from Wales, you know, not just in the defensive side, but through their court play. And it's been really good. You can see them as, you know, like players like Leah Middleton and Powell Davis, how they've been able to contest against players like Chalock and Adunye.
Oh, it's great to see Powell Davis up on her feet. It looks like she wants to stay on. She could be okay. Well, yep, she is going to stay on. Thankfully, nothing too serious.
Nothing too serious. It's always, when you have that first knock, isn't it? It's always quite painful and quite a bit of a shock for you.
But time was called, though, so she will have to come off the court, I believe.
I believe it's when a goal is scored, she might be able to come back on.
There'll have to be a stop. So Wales could have subbed on Johnson.
Yeah. But now here she comes back on. Ella Powell-Davis, ready to go.
And so 3 minutes left of this first half. 21 to Wales, 25 to Uganda. Wales in red, they go long into Georgia Rowe. Lovely pinpoint pass by Yarrington. She kept her hands over her head. She liked that one.
She did want that one. That was a lovely pass. She saw Rowe. And the injured, now much better, Powell-Davis gets that first turnover from the Uganda centre pass. Beautifully won, nice and clean.
Well, a spark has gone into her. Can her teammates reward her? Morgan at centre on the circle as she leaves it for Dwyer. Oh, great fake. But it enabled Yarrington moving out enabled that to open up for Rowe.
Again, Yarrington is so good at this. She will drive out to pocket just enough to take a defender with her, giving Rowe all the space she needs for that ball.
So just a two-point game. This is what we love. Nice and tight for the neutral.
This is what we like. Of course it is. And, you know, for being a second quarter from last night's match, this is what we didn't get at the second quarter. Uganda almost ran away with it in the second quarter for that match. So it's lovely to see this at this point in the match.
Yeah, well, it was 24 to Wales, 30 to Uganda at the end of that second quarter yesterday. And Yarrington from distance. Oh, it just bubbled out. Don't you just hate those?
Just hit that post in the wrong end, the wrong side of it.
So 1.5 minutes left of the second quarter. Bagala, centre, can't find Chollock on that long drive. And then contact called. Nikito, a goal defence. She will need to come back and set the penalty. James Thomas rightly calling her back.
Yarrington again, all the way up at her defensive transverse line, doing the defensive work and winning the turnover.
So with that, Yarrington finds herself in all heaps of space. Nikito just clips the back of Morgan's legs as she tried to haul herself back into the circle to help her defensive teammate. Kadondi draws a contact and Yarrington, she nets. Just one goal difference in them. 48 seconds on the clock. 24 plays 25. Uganda centre pass. Bagalo finds Achola. Oh, Wales are so heavy on that defence, but they go over the top. The release from Chollock.
That defensive setup is exactly what you want to see from Wales, and it was beautiful to watch. But that ball over the top to Chollock, like you said before, it's very hard to stop, isn't it? But here come Wales with 20 seconds left on the clock.
Adwaya tried to let it roll to give herself a little bit more of an advantage, getting close to the post. Adunia found herself offside. 7 seconds. Wales need to be quick. It was advanced. Yarrington, obstruction called. This is tense. The buzzer went, but the contact had been called, and Wales bring this game back to a one-goal game. Philippa Yarrington is buzzing. Wales 25, Uganda 26. What did Wales do in that second quarter to pull that back?
What a second quarter. What an absolute performance by Wales. Their defensive setup was much, much better. We saw it right at the end there when they saw how much time was left on the clock. And Uganda had to send that long ball. And that's what more we want to see from Wales. Uganda then have to either play short, sharp passes or they have to send that long ball, which gives the chance for Middleton or Powell-Davis to go for those flies. And that's what we want to see from Wales.
Well, we saw that for Middleton, didn't we? Get the view. They kept Uganda to just 9 goals. That is almost unheard of.
That is absolutely brilliant play from Wales. And, you know, Powell-Davis having been knocked down and coming back up, like you said, it's almost like she found an extra spark after she got back up. She took two turnovers in that 2 minutes. So, yeah, wonderful play from Wales in that second half.
Well, this final test match is proving to be energetic, to be the fire, to be what we wanted to see when the series is tied. Tonight, at the end of the 60 minutes, we will know who will lift that trophy. But currently in halftime, it's Wales 25, Uganda 26. Oh, come back for this second half. We will see you shortly. Welcome back to this third and final test match between Wales and Uganda. The first test on Wednesday was won by Wales in a historic win of 57 to 45. The second test, Uganda came back firing. They won that 40 to 64. And now it is just a one goal game. 25 to 26. Uganda up by one. After they came flying out in that first quarter, they took it 12-17. But Wales were able to pull it back 13 to 9 to get this scoreline. Eline.
Oh, what a quarter for Wales and Uganda. That was a really, really nice quarter to watch, with both teams really putting it out there on the court. And it was physical, as we saw, bodies on the floor all over. But it's the physicality they bring to these matches that makes it a nice game to see. The umpires letting the contested play go, not calling too much contact. It was really nice to watch. No change, I don't think, for Wales in this lineup. So they're keeping their seven the same. And Uganda, I think, the same as well. So it'll be nice to see that contest continuing on. And Wales and Uganda both being able to bring on that same passion and drive for this next quarter.
Eline, Wales brought on Ellen Morgan at centre, getting her first cap, first time in the squad. What role does she play in helping that attacking and defensive ends?
Oh, she was amazing for her first time on the court with Wales. She brought on defensively. She took turnovers. She was defensively marking Bagala so closely. She was limiting her drives. We know that Bagala likes to drive deep into pocket as well as hitting circle edge, top of circle edge quite strongly. So Morgan was stopping that drive and making sure she had to have different areas of pocket to drive to. So it was really nice to watch her. And then attackingly, she herself was hitting circle edge really nicely, working really nicely with O'Dwyer in wing attack and also Yarrington in goal attack. So yeah, really nice start from Ellen Morgan.
And for Uganda, they obviously a great first quarter. Second quarter, not where they would have wanted to be. What would Fred Magura, the head coach, be saying at halftime to them?
So I think for them, they need to reincorporate that depth that they were getting on the game last night. You know, we know that Achiuwa has the strength and the ability to be able to go into that depth onto the court. But as you were saying that, I believe they have taken her off the court, as I've just seen her putting a coat on the bench. So back into that wing attack position, we see they're starting a wing attack from Wednesday night back onto the court, which will be Adunye.
No. Sarah Nakiyunga.
Nakiyunga is back on a wing attack for Uganda. A different style of play, but also able to hit that circle edge very strongly.
So as we get ourselves ready for the second half of this final test match, two umpires, Leonard Masso, he hands the ball over to Bagalo at centre and gets us going. James Thomas working with him at the top of your screens, and it's Paul Davis comes out with that first intercepts at goal defence.
Wales be very happy with that first turnover, getting that first ball, and Uganda straight back in with a turnover from Kadunde.
Kadunde not able to keep that ball on the court, so it will stay in Welsh hands. Yarrington takes the back line to Morgan. Receives it back herself. And she nets. 26-26 with Wales centre pass. Trademark from Nia Jones to come out to help for that first phase on the centre pass.
Definitely. And you see her working really well with Powell Davis on that one. They kind of work like a little pulley system. So if Jones is coming out, Powell Davis will stay back equally the other way around. And it was really helpful then because you can see Jones drew in both attackers with her, leaving Powell Davis being able to stay with just her own wing attack and then being able to take that second ball then.
So Wales, they make it to Bagala at centre. Pressure on the line from Wales, but Uganda managed to find themselves. Adunio, wing defence. Chollock, she won't shoot from that distance. Nakinyunga is there to support her. And a feed in. Great take, great shot. Uganda get their first one of this quarter. A quick pass there from Morgan and Yarrington. What did the Ugandan defence need to do to stop that kind of just going in, it seems, really easily?
Yeah, the athleticism is really coming through there from Ellen Morgan, but Uganda need to stop the drive. So if they see that little 1-2 going between them both, you need to shut down the drive from the centre. So Bagler needs to be tighter on Ellen Morgan there to stop her from being able to come through on that drive and confuse the space. So shut down the space between them and cause her to drive, get ball side onto it. So make sure that one is that third phase of defence, isn't it? So when the ball is gone, you shut down and meet your player to shut down the drive that she's then heading into.
That ball just trickling into the goal. As long as it goes through, that's all you need. It doesn't matter how, and a great vision there from Nia Jones and that no-look pass from Yarrington. This time it doesn't come off. The defence of Kadondi and Nikito really getting up on that. Nikito to Bagala, Nakinyonga. Nice offload there from Chollock and then rolls herself into the backspace, but it's called back for the contact. Uganda recycling that ball well.
Yeah, really well. And, you know, it's not always about putting the high ball in straight away to Chollock there. It's really important to be able to recycle that ball. You know, some low passes in to Iyaru and some low passes in across the circle. It's like we see that over the head ball there went over the back line. So it's really important to be able to keep recycling and resetting, because it's not about how fast you can do it, but how well you can do it.
Yeah, and we've talked about it consistently during this game in terms of that first ball out after Wales have got a turnover. They give it straight back to Uganda, but great setup there from Bagala.
Yeah, great setup to be able to read that drive and that ball. It's really important after you turn over the ball not to get overexcited with it and to be able to give that nice pass straight out. Another change here happening for Uganda. Wing defence, Adunia has come off the court.
And Uganda able to stretch this out now to a three-goal game, 28 plays 31.
And unlucky there for Leah Middleton. She really went for that ball, but was pulled for contact against the captain of Uganda.
Yarrington doing a whole heap of work to bring this attacking ball down, and a lovely fake pass from Shona Odwyer. The step change from Rowe brings their tally to 29.
Great feed there, and again from Bagala straight into Chollock.
And it's Namburige, a wing defence come on for Uganda, who stops that pass going, causes the long ball in for Uganda to challenge.
No, Dwyer just dropped that ball there because of the pressure as well from Bagala in the centre position.
Just need to get rid of this second ball that's hovering around. And then Shona Dwyer can take that sideline. goes back to Jones. O'Dwyer, Yarrington in the middle of the third. O'Dwyer again, taking every other ball. And that quick turn from Rowe gets her defender, Kadondi, in an obstruction position. She can take a little step forward.
Yeah, it gets her off her back. And it's important for shooters to be able to do that. Even if you know you might not shoot from that area, you turn off, get the defender off your back and give yourself a little bit more space in that circle to shoot.
Tolok, I've got a backpack of Leah Middleton on her. Still strength to go up and take the ball.
Georgia Rowe doubled up there by both defenders, but still managed to collect the ball. Yarrington's draw wasn't as effective that time to pocket.
Right, so when yes, it did land, but if you see two people doubled on Rowe, Yarrington must be free somewhere. So look up and scan for her.
Yeah, she was free. She was free as a bird, just almost to the pocket of that D. So for Shauna O'Dwyer, she could have looked for Yarrington and do a little 1-2 with her for that ball. But sometimes you get tunnel vision for your tall shooters, and it happens in almost every team, unfortunately.
Iyaru, goal attack for Uganda, gets another goal to her name. 31 plays 35, coming up to the 7-minute mark of this quarter. Oh, high ball there, but Morgan, she gets up nice and tall. So, Nambirige, intentional obstruction at the top of the circle, so the ball now gets advanced. That's the best part of game management is proactive advice. The second part is that advancement before you then get to the warning, suspensions and ordering off.
Yeah, as part of the new rules we've seen, so there's no more caution to be given.
Pinpoint passing. Charlotte takes a step to the baseline, giving herself a better angle. She scores a goal. Quick off the centre pass for Wales. 1-2-3, bang onto the post.
And that's the kind of play for Wales that's really working for them. That fast-paced, quick, short passes.
It doesn't allow Uganda to set up.
No, it doesn't. It doesn't allow them at all. And when we are able to see that when Wales can run through the centre circle, almost as if they're still in the moment of play when they're setting up that centre pass, it's really fast and easy for them to do so. And Ella Morgan's athleticism comes into play with that. And Uganda prefer that kind of nice and easy, relaxed pace, like we have been saying, which is working for them, like we've just seen in that goal there by Trollock.
Great timing. That movement. This time, Yarrington was able to draw one of the defenders, which opened up Georgia Rowe.
Yeah, that draw was lovely by Yarrington. She went around the back of the post, off the court, back onto the court, just confusing the space for the defenders there.
Tolok slaps hand. She's disappointed with herself for that shortness on the shot. But second time, she goes a little bit higher and it doesn't even skim the ring. Oh, this time round, they try the quick pass. Yarrington just needed to take her feet a little bit further. She stopped.
Just an extra step for Yarrington on that one. And I believe there was a little tip as well from the goal defence there for Uganda, which is now obviously Nakito. She did manage to get a tip on that ball before Kadondi did pick up on that free ball.
Nice offload from Cholok. Nakiyunga has come on, very different type of player to Achola, who started the game. But that ability for Uganda to change up that wing attack, to bring a different kind of style to their game, really adds strength to their bow.
Yeah, it does. It adds strength to and depth to their bench. As we see, Achola is very much that kind of depth, short, sharp movement and that speed and agility, whereas Nakayunga is able to hold her space well, is strong holding her space and can have more of a short, sharp passes without that depth. It was missing from them on Wednesday night, but they have managed to bring it back into this match now on tonight.
Yeah. Uganda had managed to stretch that 1 point lead to 6. Wales with a chance to bring it down to 5. And Georgia Rowe says, yes, please. 35 plays 40. In this last test match of the series. It's one apiece. So whoever wins this will lift that trophy. And Nakayunga, she does a few footwork steps to get herself free. Middleton trying to roll the backspace, but that was good placement, Paul, into Mary Chollock. So she had no hope of getting a hand to it.
No, she held her space very well there in the front. She had the front space, knowing that she could split to get her backspace as well as her goal attack captain, Yara, running the space around her.
Nikito trying to work her feet. Her and Kadondi just confusing, trying to get in front, trying to disrupt. But it doesn't disrupt Yarrington.
Yarrington working really well there with O'Dwyer, you know, dropping that little ball, then backing herself onto the defence, making sure that all her space that she needs is hers.
Oh, that was a big challenge there from Nia Jones. On to Bargala.
She committed to that run and then pulled out last second, but it wasn't quite enough.
Bagala still clutching her side, but she's able to put that feed into Mary Chollock. Now 6 goals back for Uganda. Just under 2 minutes left of this third quarter. It's just been going back and forth, back and forth. That second quarter, Wales were able to pull it back to just 1. Uganda have come out of the halftime break a little bit more in it.
We can see the fire building in Uganda now, can't we, for the second half. They've come out of the changing rooms after halftime thinking with a 1 goal in it, we need to extend this lead. And that's exactly what they're doing. They're calm, they're collected, they're composed. They're playing their own game, not letting Wales disrupt them.
And that's the calmness needed. Yarrington into Rowe and Rowe to shoot. Iyaru, captain, she goes long. Oh, great take from Bagala and oh, lovely into Chollock, who scores.
Beautiful ball from Bagala. She almost saw that Middleton had come for that interception and she knew that her teammate was free. Almost a no-look pass from in the air.
Oh, how did that ball get through?
Talking about no-look passes, I don't think Georgia Rowe was looking for that pass, but she definitely managed to gain possession of it and put it up in the net.
Always have your hands up. You never know when the ball might come and you don't want to get hit in the face. So Yaru steps in, lays it off to Charlotte. Powell Davis tried to get the fingertips to it, but contact called. 10 seconds left on the clock. Wales will take their time if they're sensible and run this clock down. Morgan did very well as a newbie into this side. Third quarter, Wales 38, Uganda 44. Much better from Uganda compared to that second quarter.
Yeah, much better. They definitely come out of that changing room at half time with a little bit more fire in them. We know how much their coach likes to talk about their passion and how much they need to bring to the, not just tactically and technically, but how much passion they need to bring to their play. Wales, consistent, still coming out and doing what they need to be done. Defensively at the start of the quarter, much, much stronger. Might have dropped it a little bit then towards the end, but they're working hard in that defensive circle. Defensively, again, through court, like we saw last night, might be dropping a little bit. So we need to pick that up now for Wales. They need to make sure that they are following it through court, and the transition is a smooth process.
Well, Uganda scored 17 in the first quarter, 9 in that second quarter, and now they're backed up an 18. Is there a scoring end? I don't know, but Wales have been quite consistent. 12, 13, 13.
Yeah, so attackingly for Wales, like we said, consistent. But defensively in their second quarter for Wales, they were much, much harder on defence and much stronger man-on-man defence, as well as being able to set up that defensive diamond setup. It was a little bit lacking in that quarter for Wales. So they were man-on-man was not as strong. And because that wasn't as strong, they weren't able to set up that diamond setup that they're looking for. So they need to go back to that game plan of that. I'm sure Natalie Roddy will be talking about that with them now, making sure that they are able to keep the Ugandan players as wide as they can, or they're bringing it up to keep them as a, you know, into the middle and squeezing them together so they can't just let them run around freely and have all the space they want. Attackingly, they were playing very well. Philippa Yarrington able to find all the space she wants and working well with Rowe. Rowe being doubled up, of course, by Kadondi and Nambirige at the moment. My apologies, Nikito is now into a goal defence. So they are doubling up on her, making sure she can't have every single ball blown into her. So defensively from Uganda, very, very strong on the Wales attack.
How do Wales then get this deficit reduced even further and potentially come out with the win?
So, of course, firstly, they have to score every centre pass that they're given. You can't expect to win by losing your own ball, because then it's not just about how many turnovers you can have, but you increase that number of turnover because you've lost your own ball at the same time. So they have to keep composed on their centre passes, reduce the number of unforced errors, reduce the number of balls being thrown and not landing on accuracy, being composed in the circle and just working the ball in, making sure that we're not rushing passes and rushing balls, reducing the number of balls they're throwing away from the turnover like we have seen all game. So it's not just about being defensive against Uganda, but their attacking play needs to be consistent as well.
Yeah. Well, one of the elements that Emily Handyside was talking about from the first test with their centre pass to goal ratio wasn't where they wanted to be. And if you get 50% of possession, don't you? Every centre pass alternates. So that's one key area where you can really make a difference in a game.
Absolutely. And if you get 50% of possession through the whole game, then if you lose 50% of that, that's 25% possession. So we need to make sure now that Wales need to keep 50% of possession of the ball. And if you add on 25% turnover, that's 75% possession. So the turnover ball that they are taking, they are getting a high level of turnover ball, but it's the throwing away the ball and losing the ball straight after the turnover that they are losing at the moment.
Right. Well, we are all set now for the last quarter, the final quarter of this three series test match. Wales versus Uganda, Welsh Feathers versus the Ugandan She Cranes. Just having a scan again, as we always do, to see if there's any changes to either side. 7 on court. And I think Nisanga is coming on at goal attack for Uganda. And Morgan takes the first centre pass. Yarrington to Jones. Can't find O'Dwyer. But then, it's like they passed on that tray off the turnover, unable to capitalise for Uganda.
Quite a lucky ball there for Wales, because it's a centre pass that they need to score and need to keep, like we said, to keep that 50% possession.
So defensive end looks to have stayed the same, with Nambirige at wing defence, Kudondi at goalkeeper, and Nikito at goal defence. Bargala gets called for contact, centre. Yarrington finds that front space again, and she finds the goal.
We've talked about it over the past few matches as well, but Yarrington's shooting action is always so consistent and so wonderful. The ball will just lift and drop really lovely into that net.
There's Nasanga now at goal attack, takes it off, passes it to Bagala, and oh, that vision, how quick she can turn. And that's so key for other centres and wing attacks. Look at anyone, actually. When you get the ball, turn quickly, sight your shooter. You might not pass it to them, but at least you get the defenders moving off.
Yeah, sight the shooter. Always turn post when you take that ball, because that's the direction you want to go. So if you turn your head and have a look, and if they're on, give that ball. And someone like Mary Trollock will always have her space ready for her, because he's that kind of shooter. So if it's on, we've seen it so many times by the Ugandan She Cranes, they will have a look and give it every single time it's possible.
So Nasanga just needing to back up to set that penalty where Liam Middleton is stood. Pal Davis helps out, and well, I say helps out, but she kind of did it so that she could get herself in a good defensive position.
All the little tips and tricks as a defender.
You could see Yarrington calling for it, but Uganda defence were marking that space. So as a feeder, you wouldn't be comfortable passing that in, would you?
No, and sometimes as shooters, all you can see is what's in front of you. So it's important for those feeders and your midcourt to see what's behind you, because you can't see it. So it was a very, very good call from O'Dwyer to keep playing with Georgia Rowe and to making sure that she can play herself in, because Yarrington was clearly double marked.
And the 3 second call from the Wales bench, and also from the umpire's whistle. Great push up from Wales. Uganda had nowhere to go.
Keeping possession of this ball is crucial for Wales now to gain that all important turnover. With a goal difference still within five.
Oh, Wales, good timing from Kadondi, a goalkeeper.
It was great timing. She saw it and she went for it. Just couldn't quite get her feet to it. But now Wales have lost the ball again off the back line. And Uganda will have got their own possession of their own ball back.
Right, early pressure from Wales, trying to win this ball early. But Nasanga, she's all the way up to that transverse line. She's got a long way to go back to get into that goal shooting circle. Yarrington and Morgan, all the defence from the attack for Wales, trying to get this ball to go backwards. But then the pressure just released.
We're seeing great pressure from the Welsh defence here. We're seeing they're moving as a unit, all through the court, all moving, following the ball and the players. So they're not letting up on the pressure. But as you said, once that one call is made for contact or obstruction, then the pressure is just released straight away.
And that delayed entry from Nasanga, the quick 1-2 with Nakinyunga, and she's under the post and she scores. 41 plays 47. 6-goal different with coming up to 10 minutes left of this last quarter. Oh, lovely baseline drive. I used to love those.
Wonderful drive by Philippa Yarrington, that one. And Georgia Rowe, again, turning her head to post, looking for her teammate and seeing her wonderful drive and pinpoint accuracy on that pass.
Oh, almost there, living on the edge, Nasanga, but she finds Nakinyunga. And Charlotte can't put it in.
Ellen Morgan being pulled up for contact there on the ball against the centre, Bagala.
There's a few now, and I think that will come with experience as she gets more game time, just knowing when to pull out of stuff and when to challenge.
Yeah, because Leah Middleton was going for that ball as well, and she was just really coming to gather up that loose ball because Trollock had already played it and dropped it, so she couldn't pick it up for fear of replayed ball called.
That is one of the unforced errors that you mentioned. Just having that patience to wait for something to come. Uganda, back with possession. Baga. Just patiently using the width, using those angles, driving and cutting. And just waiting for Wales to make those errors and give a contact or an obstruction. And then they can set themselves up again.
What's working well for Uganda is that they are capitalising on all their own centre passes. And that's what we're seeing the difference here for Wales and Uganda. So they will score their own centre passes without losing many of their own balls. And then they capitalise, like you said, on Wales' errors.
Misanga, I think yet to miss since coming on.
Yeah, very high shooting stats from her for this match. She has been playing very well, finding her space and working well with her attacking combination.
Oh, fabulous work there from Kodondi, goalkeeper, to come out. When she times that run out, it's so good, isn't it? It's so beautiful. Clean.
Yeah, and her vision is coming through when she sights it and she just goes for that ball and she takes her feet with her to making sure that she can take it cleanly.
Well, we've been treated to some great netball these past three tests, and we're going to see Uganda again in the Nations Cup. They're going to come up against Australian Diamonds, New Zealand Silver Ferns, and the England Roses starting next week. So lots more high-quality international netball on our screens. Seven minutes left on the clock, 42-52. Uganda have upped it a bit more, extended that lead. Oh, and with mistakes like that, where we hadn't seen that shooter-to-shooter passing had been so on point, hadn't it? But this time, Georgia Rowe lets it go off the back line.
Georgia Rowe just turned the wrong way around then and let the ball kind of went rolled off her back a little bit. So yeah, unfortunate for Wales, but not something we see very often for them. But the pressure from the Ugandan defence clearly working very well for them.
And there we see it again, those tips, that forcing. But Wales, so good to set up early.
Very good set up early. And Wales' transition from defence into attack is much slicker on this match tonight. We saw it just then when there was a drop ball and Jones picked up and there was three little quick passes. And now we're straight back to Georgia Rowe.
And just that simple, easy, calm, composed play from Uganda. Just quietens the crowd.
Always quietens the crowd. But that's their style of play and that's what's working for them. They're always so cool and calm on their own attack. Then when they turn to defence, they will bring that feistiness to win back ball.
Contact on Nakiyunga, wing attack for Uganda. You can see Uganda playing that split circles. It's not really going one-on-one, but marking that space.
Confusing the space for the Welsh.
Oh, what a take. Bagala, she is a queen. She has not stopped running all game and was able to get that turnover for a team, but footwork called.
And this is where Wales need to do that quick transitional play because they then can be ahead of the Ugandan game. And we do take that second to stop and to reevaluate. It does take them that extra second and lets Uganda set up.
Rose, shooting circle now for us. A little bit rattled. They don't want to shoot or it's dropping short.
Nikita coming in with that tip as well off Georgia Rose ball.
Mm-hmm.
And a little shove from Nikita.
So that advancement has happened. Even though they're already under the post, you still have to say advance. From that contact call. And Roe nets. 44 plays 53. Coming up to the 4 minute mark of this very last quarter. Uganda currently sitting in front, ready to lift that trophy, but potentially still time for Wales to get back into this game.
Yeah, I've seen it done before. You know, I've been myself down 12 goals and to come back to win by seven, so it's easily done.
So we're just having a little ball swap. Charlock leaves it for her teammate, Leah Middleton, to try spinning up, but you do have to set the penalty first, so she can't be that quick.
It's worth a go.
Wales, bring it back to nine. But as you were saying, Uganda are so clinical on their centre pass. Wales unable to cut that deficit.
Yeah, they are very clinical. And like I said, they're very cool and collected, and they will make sure to take their time to score on their own centre pass. A couple extra passes will make a difference to get that ball into Mary Charlock.
And the clock is on their side. So another advancement from that contact. Dwyer takes on the edge of the circle. Yarrington, no look pass into Rowe. Rowe scores. Much better performance from Wales than Friday night, but still just not enough to combat this Ugandan side.
Yes, much, much better performance from Wales tonight. We can see that it's almost as if that less recovery time has made a difference for them to be better. But we're seeing a lot more different combinations, you know, in the way they're playing together. Ellen Morgan has come into the squad, and she's really showing that she deserves to be here, and she's making a really great impact.
And less changes, though. As I say, only Ellen Morgan coming in, and the only other change was Bethan Dyke going to the bench and O'Dwyer going to wing attack. So potentially having a more consistent side helping.
Yeah, it's not often we see Bethan Dyke taken to the bench, but it also shows the depth that Wales have got on the bench, which is really nice to see, that we can bring on, you know, these other new players like Ellen Morgan, and utilising experienced players like Shona O'Dwyer to fill in those positions like at wing attack, which she is very good at playing, to be able to give Bethan Dyke, you know, rest on the bench and put back on if needed. But it's really nice to see the depth that Wales have been able to get over the past few years. Mm-hmm.
And for Uganda, we're seeing so much depth from their side. They've been able to ring in the changes, hasn't, whether it's been an injury or whether it's a tactical change needed. But whoever stepped on court has then kept that momentum going, if not lifted.
Yeah, so many changes from Uganda. And it's been really nice to see, you know, we've seen that there we can put wing defences in goal defence positions, and we can put centres into wing attacks. And they brought on as many players off the bench as they could, and it's nice to see them do that before they head on now to their next games against England and New Zealand and Australia. And it's really important for them to have all players have a little run out and move their legs and have the experience of playing these kind of matches.
It's one thing training, isn't it, but it's another thing stepping out onto the court in an international test match. And coming up to 30 minutes left of this very last quarter, Philippa Yarrington, as she's been doing countless times, gets the ball on the baseline, puts it through the net, and a thumbs up. Bagala with a ball. Nasanga straight into Charlock. A layup, the first time of the game, puts it through. 14
seconds.
Waiting
for that layup, haven't we, from Charlock, and there it is.
And they've got 8 seconds left. Are they going to be quick? Oh, that ball goes in long, but Charlock, and again, step just falls short this time round. Goes through the net, counting. One of those new rules. As long as the ball has left the player's hands, when the whistle goes, it will count. Uganda win the test series 2-1. This match, 48-59. Elaine, for you, what was the most crucial point for Uganda in terms of being able to ride out that wave and come out with the victory?
They were definitely much more collective and calm on this match than they were yesterday. I feel like yesterday maybe they were a bit, they brought a bit more feistiness as they were coming back from the loss on Wednesday. So they were much more, they didn't have as much to prove maybe on this match. They were able to just enjoy themselves, enjoy that match, knowing that they will be able to bring it. And Wales definitely came back with a bang on this match. They coming back off the loss yesterday, they brought it back to the defensively, and they brought the deficit between the scores to much less than it was yesterday. So credit to both teams for what they performed out there tonight. But Uganda obviously coming up with a win, as should be expected from their world rankings.
Yeah. And this is the part of the game I always love. You fought and battled against each other. You were fierce opponents on the court. But once that final whistle goes, a lot of respect for each other, and a great way to close out that test series.
Yeah, you know, we always see it. We always love it. On the netball court, you can battle it out and battle it out and almost become to hate each other. But no, as at the end of the match, you all come together, one big cuddle. You say thanks to each other and you give little comments to each other. And we're always one big team at the end, aren't we? And it's lovely to see.
Let's start with Wales, though, in terms of what would Emily Handyside and Natalie Roddy and the coaching staff have learned from what Wales have put out in this past three games that they can use, because they've always talked about it's the long game. It's not just about this start of 4 year cycle, but going through the next 4 years. What can they take to take them forward?
So the long game for Wales is quite an exciting one, I think. They've managed to put on these like new experienced players, these new players that not experienced in the Wales setup, but experienced in the Super League setup and the NPL setup as well. So it's really nice to see they've been able to bring on the new players, almost all six of them, to get their first caps. And I think that the depth they've got on the bench that we previously talked about is really exciting for Wales. And that you can see they've already gelled really well with the experience they've got on the bench already, with the experience of co-captains Jones and Dyke, and the experience they've got in players who have played together for years in types of Yarranton and Rowe, and in the defensive circle with Ella Powell Davis. So Middleton, for example, has settled in really, really well in that defensive circle. Ellen Morgan played three quarters of a game in centre and she absolutely smashed it out of the park. So it's really exciting for what's coming up now for Wales over the next 4 years. Obviously not having the Commonwealth Games yet will not be great news for Wales, but it's showing that what they've been working on so far is something they're really to be able to watch on for.
Look out for them. And for Uganda, we mentioned they've obviously got a test series coming up, well, the Nations Cup, where they will battle it out against Australia, New Zealand and England, the top three ranked nations in the world. They're notorious for starting series slowly, and which we saw on Wednesday. But do you think they've got that next level to come up against the world number one, two and three?
We definitely see it in them. They definitely have the feistiness and the power to do so. And like you said, they are notorious for starting a bit slowly and settling into the match. So maybe they need just a little bit more focus to be able to settle in a bit quicker against these teams like the top three in the world, because they will go out there and they will start heavy and they'll finish heavy. So it's important to be able to not take too much time to settle into the match, because you won't have that time to settle into the match against these top three teams. So it is really important for them. But yeah, they definitely have the ability to do so, and they definitely have the knack to do so. So that performance they put out on there tonight was lovely to see.
Well, Georgia Rowe has been given a player of the match for this last test match. For you, what was so key in her play? What made her stand out?
Tonight, Georgia Rowe definitely deserves that player of the match position, medal, award. She was consistent, wasn't she? Her shooting stats were wonderful. She only missed a couple, I think, but she was strong in there in that shooting circle. Her partnership with Yarranton, with Morgan, with O'Dwyer, with Dyke, they knew exactly where each other were at all times. She was turning posts, she was getting defence off the back, she was drawing defence in. It's not just about how many times she puts the ball in the net, but how many times she's able to do the work around it. We saw her even come out of the shooting circle tonight for the first time in these three test matches and do the extra work needed to help her team bring that ball into circle. So definitely well deserved for Georgia Rowe.
Yeah, well, when you've got a shooter that's 6'5", you normally in some teams tend to just see them under the post, I say, but if you've got that ability to come out of the circle and be a playmaker as well, definitely adds value.
It does add value, and we see it in Uganda and Chollock. You know, she does come out and she does work that ball in, utilizing what she can to, and her strength outside of the circle, allowing then space for her goal attacks to go in and utilise it. And Georgia Rowe does do it. We have seen her do it in Team Bath and in Cardiff Dragons. Sorry, Seven Stars and in Cardiff Dragons. So for her to do it now on the Welsh stage as well, it's lovely to see. It's something that we can develop further now And hopefully we can see her do it more and more often to give Yarranton and the other goal attacks that we've been putting on court to work around that space as well.
Nice. And for Uganda, the winning side and the winning team for this series, who for you stood out?
I mean, of course, we're going to mention Chollot because she's, you can't miss her under that post, can you? She's a force to be reckoned with, and her stats tonight were absolutely wonderful. Didn't get to see much of Achula tonight as they did take her off the court. Bagler's a centre for me. Absolutely outstanding. Up and down that court. Did not stop moving. But as we just mentioned her, she has just been named player of the series. Mary Chollock, player of the series for these three test matches. She is an outstanding shooter. You cannot give her credit for that. She doesn't often miss, apart from the couple little short passes that pop on she doesn't like, maybe. But no, she is consistent, and going up against her is a test for every defender.
Well, she's had to become the leader in that attacking head, hasn't she? Prascopia Peace, who's now assistant coach for Uganda, that she's not here for this series, but we'll see her at the Nations Cup. But now the shooting falls on Mary Chollock's head. She's been there for a few tournaments now, but now it's her and her alone.
It is her. And I think we have to give credit to, you know, the goal attacks and the captain, Ziyaru. Mm-hmm. She does bring a lot of experience and talent into that shooting circle. And it's important to think that it's not just the shooter that it falls on her shoulders, but being a 6 foot, seven, 6 foot six as she is, it will automatically fall on her almost. So, but she always can rely on those goal attacks because she didn't take every single ball and she put every single shot up. It's important to recognize that the goal attacks that came onto the court did their part and did their own play as well. So they are very much a shooting unit in Uganda.
And an attacking unit as well, isn't it? As you say, the goal attacks really were those playmaking positions, but the likes of Bagala, as you mentioned, or both wing attacks, Achola or Naki Yunga that came on, all know their role in the team, it seems like, and they're able to put out those high performances because everyone knows what their job is.
Yeah, an attacking unit, absolutely. And even playing defensively as well. We see them come all the way up to the transverse line to do their job. And the goal attacks almost as if they've come on to this role equally that we see in both teams. But yes, attacking unit, they everyone knows what their job is, and they do it so well and so consistent through the court. And that's what we see from Uganda. And we see them, how they then capitalise on all their centre passes, like we mentioned. So credit to, you know, to the attacking side and also the defensive side. They played very, very well and very well deserved the win tonight.
Wow, we're just waiting now to have the presentation for Uganda to get their series win trophy. It's been such a great atmosphere, hasn't it, been here? Like, the fans have really come out to support both sides. For Wales, there was obviously a lot of noise going on, but we've seen some Ugandan fans scattered across, and the voice that comes and the respect for this game is just huge, isn't it?
It's massive, yeah, and it's grown a lot over the past few years here in Wales and across the UK, I believe, and it's really nice to see, and it's nice that we can have these countries come over to play here in Wales. So it's really lovely that it has grown. And equally so now to these new players that are joining into the Welsh squad, which you have now seeing a cap presentation for the new Welsh feathers. And it's absolutely lovely to see.
So, Wales feather number 222, I think I heard. And Liam Middleton comes up after she received her first cap on Wednesday. Wow, what a performance that she has. Like, first time into this Welsh setup, and she's really showing some great promise.
She's really pulled her own against in the defensive circle. It's been wonderful.
So, Welsh feather number 223, Megan Pilkington, came on at centre in the first test as well as the second test.
Yes, she did. Yes. So it was really lovely to see that as well. Held her own as much as she could as well.
And Welsh feather number 224, Alex Johnson, the 21-year-old, getting her first cap on Friday night.
Yeah, and she did hold her own in that defensive circle, adding that extra height. It was really lovely.
Welsh feather number 225, Caris Morgan.
Another force to be reckoned with in that defensive circle. She will definitely be one to watch for the next few years coming forward.
And then we have Abby Capel, Welsh feather number 226. She came on in last night's game as well at goal attack. been through various pathways and now getting an opportunity at the senior level.
Yeah, absolutely. And she definitely played extremely well last night.
And last but not least, Ellen Morgan. Coming, Welsh feather number 227. Phenomenal performance at centre. First time in the squad.
What a performance from her at centre. You know, a Team Bath player, a player who's been working through different pathways as well, like you said, for Alex Johnson. So, yeah, wonderful performance for Ellen Morgan. And definitely deserved place in this squad. And hopefully, you know, watching now over the next few years' development, she definitely is one to watch.
Yeah. Well, what a series we've been treated to. What a final game. Wales versus Uganda. Welsh feathers versus the Ugandan she cranes. It's Uganda that take this last test 48-59. They win the series 2-0. Aline, what a pleasure. Thank you again for joining me and going through this game. It's been a lot of fun. And hope you all enjoyed it. Have a great rest of your weekend, and we look forward to more international netball.